everyone. It's me, Josh. Welcome back to Storytime. This time we're going to be reading Mr. Skinny by Roger Hargreaves. Looks like an interesting little chap. Wonder what we're going to find out and read about in this story today. All right, get comfortable, get ready, because we're about to delve into Storytime. That's right. Mr. Skinny was extraordinarily thin, painfully thin. If you turned sideways, you could hardly see him at all. And what made it even worse was that he lived in a place called Fatland. Yes, Fatland. Wow, that is thin. Look, it's like almost like two lines. As you can very well imagine, everything and everybody in Fatland was as fat as could be. Not stout, fat. Fatland dogs were extremely fat. Wow. The dog's almost rolling instead of walking. Fatland worms were extraordinarily fat. Wow. Look at that worm. Mr. Skinny is out of place. Fatland birds were exceedingly fat. Look at that bird. Wow. And you should see a Fatland elephant. Phew. That is intense. And there in the middle of all of its fatness lived Mr. Skinny, in the thinnest house you've ever seen. Poor Mr. Skinny, he didn't like being so different from everything and everybody, but there wasn't very much he could do about it. You see, he had hardly any appetite at all, and a Mr. Skinny meal was a very meager affair. Well, this is a very tall, skinny house. You know what he had for breakfast? One cornflake. And for lunch, one baked bean. And for tea, nothing. And for supper, the world's smallest sausage. Gosh, I don't know if I could survive. I love my food. And after that, he felt so full he went straight to bed. In his long thin bed, in his long thin bedroom, in his long thin house in Fatland. Oh, I do so wish I could do something about my appetite. He sighed to himself just before he went to sleep. I think, he thought, that I better go and see the doctor about it. And he went to sleep. Check out. In that bed. The following morning was lovely. A large fat sun shone down on the fat green trees and the fat yellow flowers, and through them walked Mr. Skinny on his way to see the doctor. Look at the trees and the flowers in the background there. Well, Dr. Plump, come in, he wheezed as Mr. Skinny knocked at his door. Sit down, he wheezed as Mr. Skinny entered. And what, he wheezed, putting his plump fingers together, seems to be the trouble. Is Mr. Plump gonna hopefully help Mr. Skinny out with his appetite problem? It's my appetite, explained Mr. Skinny. I'd like to be able to eat more so that I could put on a little weight. Yes, you are rather, how shall I put it, thin, wheezed the doctor, looking at him over his glasses. I know, he continued. Let's start the treatment right now. He licked his lips. This very moment, he added. And he opened a drawer in his desk and took out an enormous ice cream cake. He put it on the desk in front of him and opened another drawer and took out half a dozen donuts. And put them on the desk in front of him, and opened another drawer and took out a dozen currant buns, and put them on the desk in front of him. Elevenses, he explained. But it's only 10 o'clock, said Mr. Skinny. Who's counting? Wheezed Dr. Plump. Looking forward to his drawer food. And without further ado, he and Mr. Skinny ate the lot. And Mr. Skinny ate a dab of cream, a donut crumb, and one currant. Sorry, not a currant. I don't know why I read it as currant. Sometimes you do that. You just sound it out and you read it differently. I read it as currant, because I didn't understand the context of it. It meant current. Silly me. I'm thinking about food. I'm very hungry. All this talk about food and stuff is making my belly rumble. Dr. Plump ate the rest. So Mr. Skinny had a dab of cream, a donut crumb, and one currant out of all of the food that Mr. Plump pulled out, and he ate the rest. Dr. Plump, I'm sorry. Goodness me. Wheezed Dr. Plump, popping the last currant bun into his mouth and looking at Mr. Skinny. I see, he said. What you mean about your appetite? He thought for a moment. Only one thing for it, that he wheezed. This calls for drastic measures. And he picked up his telephone in his podgy fingers and dialed a number. 100 miles away, the telephone rang. Hello, said a voice. Do you know whose voice it was? Who's that? That is Mr. Greedy. Yes. Mr. Greedy speaking, said the voice. Mr. Greedy listened to what Dr. Plump had to say. You'd like a Mr. Skinny to come to stay, he said. To build up his appetite, he added. Delighted, he agreed. And so Mr. Skinny went to stay with Mr. Greedy. He stayed for a month. And during that time, Mr. Greedy did manage to increase Mr. Skinny's appetite. And so, at the end of the month, Mr. Skinny returned home, happy. I'm waving to Mr. Greedy there. With a tummy! A tummy was something Mr. Skinny had always wanted. I never knew I had it in me, he chuckled to himself. He was feeling so proud of his tummy. He decided to call in and see Dr. Plump on his way home. Look at Mr. Skinny's little tummy there. I say, wheezed Dr. Plump, looking him up and down. Congratulations! Tell you what, he went on. This calls for a celebration. And he opened his desk drawer. What do you think he pulled out of his desk drawer this time? More sweets and desserts and yummy foods? Oh, I think I might go and make myself some food. All right. Bye for now, but not forever. If you like these stories, please click that bell below and subscribe for me. I'll see you again soon.